We're going to talk about earthquakes. Have you ever felt an earthquake? Well, you know what? This past January, some parts of South Florida felt the earth shake below them, all from an earthquake, a big one, 7.7 magnitude earthquake down in the Caribbean Sea in between Cuba and Jamaica. It is estimated that there are 500,000 earthquakes that are detectable each year around the world. 100 of those can actually be felt by humans, and about 100 of them cause damage. Now, there's the Ring of Fire. That's in the Pacific Ocean, and that's where 90% of the world's earthquakes occur each year. Why there? Well, let's talk about tectonic plates. The Earth's crust is not all in one piece. It's made up of these tectonic plates, kind of like puzzle pieces. It's formed with the Earth's crust and also a top portion of the mantle, which is the next layer below the Earth's crust. A lot of times, these tectonic plates move, and where they come together can be fault lines. They move very slowly, a couple of inches a year. Sometimes they go apart, together, or even side to side. If these tectonic plates move away from each other and one slips farther down, that would be a normal fault. Now, if these tectonic plates are pushing together and one goes up above the other, that's going to be a reverse fault. Sometimes these tectonic plates go side to side. That's going to be a strike split fault. As these plates are moving, there might be some areas that kind of get stuck, and a lot of pressure is building while the rest of the plates are still slowly moving. And pressure is going to build up. Imagine this pencil. If I put pressure on both sides of it, eventually it's going to break and snap. Now we have an earthquake. That energy is released. It's rippled out like seismic waves and ripples in a pond. Those seismic waves are felt as earthquakes. Now, the location where that release of energy happens is called the epicenter. But as you go below the surface, that point is called the hypocenter. Scientists that study earthquakes are called seismologists, and they use a seismograph to measure the intensity of earthquakes. It looks like this. The higher the amplitude of that wave is going to be the higher of intensity of the earthquake. Seismologists use a seismograph to determine the strength or intensity of an earthquake. The higher the magnitude, the more destructive the earthquake can be.